All right, welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. So normally we do this thing every day, every weekday anyway, live on Twitch at 10 a.m. and Eastern. And I really wanted to pull those videos down off of Twitch, quickly edit them so that they're not as long and tedious as the live version. Speed it up and then stick it on YouTube with some music. And that's the way we normally do it. But today I thought I'm going to do a little voiceover just to explain some things, as well as being able to chat with you because every once in a while it's good to hear a voice, right? So, first of all, these videos are definitely sped up. So that means I don't normally color at this rapid speed. But up in the right-hand corner, I believe, you have like three dots where you can go in there and check out the speed, and you can actually slow it down if you need to. So I don't know if you're aware of that, but you can do that on most every YouTube video, not just mine. Now, we did do this as kind of a series for a whole week plus a day. We worked on one reference photo. It was a picture that I had taken at the garden center at Walmart, actually, of some flowers, and I used that image to basically do a study in four different medias. And this was the final one, and we used our PolyChromos. I did the whole thing start to finish with PolyChromo pencils. These are by Faber Castell. I love them. They are oil-based pencils, so they're very rich and creamy. The color goes down really smooth. I really don't have to push very hard. I can color for hours with these without hurting my hands. The pencil lead almost never breaks. Of course, unless I push too hard. But I use what is that? Prismacolor manual pencil sharpener. The word is sharpener. I use that to get a fine point on them, and I'm not sure if you'll see that in this video. I may have cut it out, but the idea is that we did the whole picture this way, and I did use some pastel paper. It's Canson Mietientos, I think I'm saying that right, pastel paper. And then I just layered, 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 layered. Like, that's really the trick to almost every single thing that I do around here, is just layer, layer, layer. And as you see me layer, you'll see some dark parts will reveal themselves, some dark areas, which gives depth and dimension to the original shape that we put down. And I do post, when I'm doing a live stream, I do post videos as much as I can remember anyway. I post images to Instagram so that way the folks watching can actually get like a close-up view. So sometimes the camera being straight up from the image, and then being farther away, you can't really see all the details sometimes because of the live stream. The feed might be blurry or what have you. But an Instagram picture is a really neat way to see the details and whatnot. And when I was drawing this and we took some Instagram pictures, some of those pictures are just incredible. The detail of even the paper, the detail of the paper and whatnot. So you might want to check that out. If you don't follow us on Instagram, it is Kraaft Shaak on Instagram. I think there's a link down below in the description box. At least there should be. But yeah, so we do this live streaming on Twitch now because it is just easier for me to do it, first of all, and it's less detrimental to my YouTube channel to not do live streams. So YouTube is going to be where I house videos that are 30 minutes or less, usually around 20, 15, 20 minutes, and then everything live is going to be on Twitch. So if you don't follow us on Twitch, there is definitely a link below in the description for you to follow us on Twitch. And And you want to check that out because it's a daily live art adventure. We might be making backgrounds for upcoming mixed media pieces, or we might be actually doing a full-on drawing like you see here. So some of the things that I really want to share with you are about what we're going to be doing in the future. So hopefully, if you're over 5 minutes into this video already, if you're still here, hopefully you stick around for the whole thing. But we have some things coming this month that I have worked out some collaborations. I have joined a blog hop. There's going to be some things coming up this month that are hopefully things that you'll enjoy. Next month, I'm going to be doing some things for my community in September that are going to inspire folks. Now that we're getting back to school and everything, I have some ideas about inspiring folks to get out their supplies that they have and get working on some projects. And I'm kind of excited about that. I've got some things that I'm working on that I think you will be excited about. If you're not a part of our community, it's on Discord. It is basically a chat. It's a chat, really, where you can come and be a part of things with us. So, all right. So you saw there is on to part two. So this was actually a 2-day event. We did the first part that you saw there on one day, and then, gosh, I think it was a whole week later that we did this one. And actually, in between that first drawing and this drawing, I actually went on a little mini nightmare of an adventure to go rescue our motorhome from Mississippi. And if you haven't been following any of that, then this makes no sense to you. But real quick, our motorhome had broke down while we were on the southern tour meeting friends in May, and it broke down in Mississippi on our way home from that trip, and we had to leave it there so that they could work on it, and it ended up needing an entirely new engine, which is not an inexpensive it is not at all inexpensive endeavor, and it actually ended up costing almost double what they originally said it was going to cost, I guess about 50% more. We talked them down to 50% more. It started, it was triple. But anyway, so then we on our way home from rescuing that from Mississippi, we actually ran into more engine trouble. So they didn't actually fix it. So it was quite a nightmare, and when I did this video, I was just desperate for stress relief and needed to be with my friends, and that's what this was about. And in the middle of or something, Michael Daniels, if you are not familiar with Michael Daniels, he's an amazing guy. He actually sent us a $100 super chat. It actually might have happened in the other one. I'm not really sure. Anyway, he sent me a $100 super chat and made me bawl like a baby. I wasn't able to do the show. So he pops in and he says, he like helped with the screens, and it was really kind of funny. It wasn't at the moment funny for me because I was bawling like a baby, but we got over it. We had a good conversation, Michael and I did, about creativity, and we talked, the audience chimed in with some great stuff. So if you are interested in seeing those live videos, they are available on Twitch for a limited time. They don't stay on there forever. But under the videos tab on my information page, you can find all the videos that we've done so far, except for the ones that have disappeared. There's, I think, two have disappeared since we started, but kind of cool. We have over 30 daily art adventure videos over there. Kind of cool. Not all of them are gems. Some of them are tad boring. I'm making cards or whatever, but there are a few that are worth a replay for sure. So some of the things that we're going to be doing on our live streams are jelly plating to get some papers so that way we can do some collage art. Then we'll be doing some collage art. That may take a couple of episodes to get through, a couple of sessions, which is another reason why I really love the Twitch atmosphere, because I can just sort of hang out and it doesn't have to be a completed project. It doesn't have to be a show per se that has a beginning, middle, end, you know. And so I kind of like that. I like the idea of just hanging out with my friends, relax, no pressure, and that's what Twitch has done for me. So I hope that you'll join us over there if you like that kind of thing. It's a great put it on in the background type of deal, and we have conversations with audience members, and over time we might even have some guests show up, because that session with Michael, when he came in, actually really was very enjoyable. Not the part where he made me cry, but the being able to have some conversation with someone was really enjoyable, and we had a discussion about having friends join, and a few have said anytime. So we may be trying that as well in the new, in the coming months. So you want to check that out. Now, following on Twitch is totally free. It is just like being a subscriber on YouTube. You get notifications when I go live, and you can join the chat and everything else. And then if you are so inclined and want to support the Kraaft Shaak, then there's an option to actually subscribe there with and help provide an income for the Kraaft Shaak. But that's just a total side, you know, an aside there. That's not at all what it's about. Okay, so again with this image, I wanted to talk about why I chose to do three stems and leaves instead of what the original image, and I should have probably put that in this video, but the original image was really like a sea of leaves. It was mostly green with these blossoms, several blossoms like this popped in there, and I only chose to draw three of them. And then I decided I really just wanted it to not be. I didn't really want all that green. We have done in the previous versions of this study, there were several that I did with a couple that I did with a lot of green, and it looks better in the sense that it looks more like the reference photo, but it doesn't look better to me as a completed piece. So I really wanted more white space. Well, then there's all this white space, and I couldn't handle it. So, the whole time that I'm working on these leaves, in my mind, I'm thinking, what are you going to do about the background? Because this is ridiculous. And I had this idea for a gradient background, but I wasn't sure how to pull it off. And so, after thinking about it, had this idea. You're going to see it, but I had this idea to put down blue. Lots of layers of blue, and then take a blending stump and some alcohol, like isopropyl alcohol, and blend the background. So now when I was like in the mid section of this, like between day one and day two of this painting or drawing, whatever, Sandra, artfully made for you. Sandra had asked if I was going to use a blending pen to blend these, and I had no idea what she was talking about. Like a blending pen? I didn't even know. I'm trying to use pencils, so I don't know anything about a blending pen. Apparently, there are blending pens for pencils. I didn't know. And I was like, I don't know anything about that. So I did a little bit of research to find out about this, about how to blend pencils, and I watched a video where she used baby oil, and I remember, like what feels like 100 years ago, I had used Prismacolor pencils and stamps and colored all these little stamps, and then I used baby oil and a Q-tip to blend those images. And I remember the oil stains on the back of the paper, and I remember thinking, I'm never doing that again. I think that was what worried me about this. I didn't want to ruin this beautiful, I mean, we spent a lot of time on this, and it ends up being really pretty. And it's okay as it is right there. There's no reason to put in a background, but I don't know. It was just bugging me, and I decided I'm just going to lightly put in a gradient of blue, and I really focused around making those petals pop because there was nothing that defined the edge of those petals until I did that right there, up there on that one in the middle for sure, as well as the one currently on the left-hand side of the screen. Those white edges just don't, they just disappear into the white paper. So I really felt like I needed to do this. Honestly, if you were doing this, I would have left it. Now that the blue is done, I think it would have been better left white. You can actually tell me down in the comments below what you think. Better with blue or better with white? And don't try to agree with me. Just because you won't hurt my feelings. Just you tell me what you think. But just trying to, you know, give it some pop so it pulls forward and doesn't just disappear into that paper. But after the blue is done, I'm thinking maybe it would have been okay to leave them that way. Sort of mysterious. Anyway, I don't know. Whatever. I like them both. Is it possible to do both? All right, I did put a sheet of paper down because my hand was starting to pull some of that blue and some of those green, the darker colors for sure, were getting into my hand there. So definitely had to put the paper down. And it was difficult to not get too heavy-handed in some areas, and I feel like I did do that underneath those leaves there in that center one. But I think it works out in the end. There's, you know, it's like this with everything that you do, right? There's sort of an ugly stage where you're like, oh crap, I think I may have messed this whole thing up. But we get through it. Now, when editing this video, I did do quite a bit of cutting where we go from like that little bit of blue to now I've filled in all of this area. And I did that so because this video is already too long as it is. If you really are interested in all those details and you want to see it in real time and you want to see how many layers and what colors we used and whatnot, check out the live stream because that's all that information is already there. So I think we're getting close to the end here. I am going to pull out that blending stump and pour some rubbing alcohol into like the cap of a water bottle, and that'll be where I will moisten that blending stump so that way we can do some blending, and you'll see how it goes here. Here we go. So I just put it into the alcohol, blend a little bit, and we'll get through this real quickly because it's just basically that through the whole thing. Quite an awesome end result to take it from that. And I really focused the blending at the bottom corner, and then I just sort of skipped around as it went further out, and I did nothing to the left-hand side, really. Just left those as is. So peel away the tape, and that's pretty much the end of it. So I thank you for joining. I hope you have enjoyed this. Give it a thumbs up and share it if you did. Have a crafty day. Bye-bye.